Good morning, students. So 11th standard physics. So in this class we are going to discuss about parallax method. So it is a method used to find the distant objects. So what is the distance between the distant objects? So for example, distance between the earth and moon, the distance between the sun and earth, then other stars and the heavenly bodies. So first, what is my parallax? So the apparent change in the position of an object with respect to the background when the object is seen from two different positions. So I am seeing an object. So I'm seeing the pen. So I'm seeing the pen using my right eye. So with respect to the background, there is a tree is there. Now I'm closing the right eye and seeing through the left eye. So there is an apparent change. Due to the change we are seeing through the left eye and right eye. So there is an apparent change in the position of an object with respect to the background when the object is seen from two different positions. So using the left eye, using the right eye, this is a basic idea. But now I am seeing an object, it's placed at the O. So from L and R, so L is left, R is right. So the distance between the point of observation is basis. So it makes an angle theta. So I am seeing from here and here from there. So that makes an angle theta. So it makes a circle, it's the center of the circle. So it makes a radius, that OL and OR are the radii of the circle. So that LR, that basis, is a arc length of the circle. So consider as a circle of radius R. So R is the distance, that is OR or OL. It makes an angle theta. So the angle theta equal to arc length by radius. So the arc length formula. So theta equal to arc length by radius. So arc length is basis. So B, then the radius, that is OL or OR, then X. So from this idea we are going to find that is how to determine the distance of the moon from the earth. So again the idea is somewhat different. So to see the moon, so first theta is a parallactic angle, so X is a distance. If distance is more, angle is somewhat very less. So to increase the angle, so the basis, that is distance between the two position, that is point of observation, should be large. So for that, so consider the air, C is the center of the earth. So A and B are the diametrically opposite points of observation. So that two distance from A to B, the distance is somewhat very high. So to make a greater parallactic angle, so from point A I am watching a distance, I am seeing a distant star just right. So it makes an angle. So using an astronomical telescope, so now I am shifting to see the moon through the telescope, it makes an angle theta. So now first I see the star, now I rotate the star, I rotate the telescope and see the moon, so it makes an angle theta. So similarly at the point B I am observing a distant star straight, so again I make an angle theta and see the moon. So theta 1, theta 2 are the parallactic angles. So theta 1 plus theta 2 equal to theta. So angle AMB equal to theta, that is theta 1 plus theta. So how it came? So first, see, it's a equilateral triangle, all sides are equal. So all the angles 60 degree, sum of the angles 180 degree. So now make a perpendicular line to the base. So this one is theta 1, this one is theta 2. So theta 1 plus theta 2 is theta. So this is a formula. So just come down. So this 60 degree. So this one 90 minus 60, so because it's perpendicular, so it makes an angle 90 with the base. So it's 30 degrees, so it should be 30. So 30 plus 30 60. So theta 1 plus theta 2 equal to theta. So theta equal to AM by AB. How? Again the same. So this is a basis, this is a radian. So we are measuring the angle in terms of radian. So theta is equal to arc length by radius. So arc length is AB by AM. So AB by AM. So AM is approximately equal to MC. So MC is a perpendicular distance towards the center of the earth. So that MC is equal to AM, that is approximately. So make it. So instead of AM, write MC. So we need the distance between the earth to moon. So MC is equal to just rearrange. MC is equal to AB by theta. So MC is X. So X distance, then AB is the basis. So X is equal to B by theta. So we are using two formulas, one is arc formula and theta 1 plus theta 2 equal to theta. So these things, if you understand very clearly, you can write it very nice.